Hello, this is Shesha Chama from Astro Guide Mysore. Today let us go through the table of Vashya Koota. Here Vashya Koota is one of the marriage matching kootas. We have seen yesterday Graha Maitri, and before that we have seen Rashi Koota, which was nothing but the Bhakuta Koota. In the Graha Maitri, I forgot telling the result of that particular koota. It is more of psychological and intellectual understanding between, even the emotional understanding between the couple, the bride and the groom. So, if the Graha Maitri is good, then there will be very good understanding between them. So, now we are today seeing Vashya Koota. Vashya Koota is nothing but attraction between the bride and the bridegroom, that is the boy and the girl. This attraction is mostly physical attraction, and this is a koota which has to be seen along with the yoni koota, so that we need to see what sort of a mental makeup is there which will make the person, you know, both of them get attracted to each other. So this is most of what we get like regular karmic attraction. When two people see each other, they get attracted to each other. So that attraction is required in a marriage, and that is very important, and let us go through it. So this is the traditional table as to, you will get 2 points if this matches. So very simple it is, but it is complicated when I go to the real analysis of why this is done. So here, for the bride, I have just written all the 12 Rashis: Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius and Pisces. So matching to that, for Aries, Leo and Scorpio are set to give Vashya Koota. So other than that, if it is a Aries bride, that is a girl is Aries and boy is Leo and Scorpio, then you get 2 points, or else no, 0 points. So, whether it is 0, 1 or 2, we will think about it later, because in the higher level classification of Vashya Koota, there are some differences, higher level of research which has been done, which actually gives you 1 point also in between, which we will talk later. But here, as per the traditional table, it is either 0 or 2. So, Aries matches with Leo and Scorpio, Taurus matches with Cancer and Libra, Gemini matches with Virgo, Cancer matches with Scorpio and Sagittarius, Leo matches with Libra, Virgo matches with Gemini and Pisces, Libra with Capricorn and Virgo, Scorpio with Cancer, Sagittarius with Pisces, Capricorn with Aries and Aquarius, and Aquarius with Aries, and Pisces with Capricorn. So, if this is the girl's Rashi, that is where the moon is placed, and if this is the boy's Rashi, where Janma Rashi, where the moon is placed in the horoscope, then the matching is good and we give 2 points in the koota system. Now let us understand why this Vashya Koota was done in such a way. Because if you see here, you can understand that the classification of Aries, Taurus, the first half of Capricorn, the first half of Capricorn is Chatushpada Rashi, Chatushpada, it's a goat. The second half is Jalachara, it's a crocodile. So, the first half of Capricorn and the second half of Sagittarius. The first half of Sagittarius, we know it's human. And the second half of Sagittarius is a horse. So, here, if we see Aries, Taurus, first half of Capricorn and second half of Sagittarius come under four-legged herbivores. Let us be very clear. Not four-legged, all four-legged animals. Four-legged herbivores, Chatushpada Rashi, what we call as Chatushpada. Next, the second classification is Gemini, Virgo, Aquarius, where we see a human being, twins. A Virgo is a virgin girl or a kanya, and Aquarius is a woman with a pot filled with water, and the first half of Sagittarius, which is a man. So all these are human, so they have the human qualities. All the human being qualities are there in this. The herbivore qualities are there in this. Here the third classification is Cancer, Pisces. Cancer is the Jalachara, that is water animals. Cancer, you know, it is a crab. So Pisces is fish. So once again, Jalachara. The second half of Capricorn is what I told as the crocodile. So you have three water body animals here. So I have written water there. So fourth classification is Leo, which is a beast. It is a carnivore. Though it is four-legged, it is a carnivore. So the fifth classification is Scorpio, which is a Keta, which is an arthropoda, which has eight legs, and it is a scorpion. So this is, none of the classifications are matching with this. This is separate. The sixth one is Libra, which is actually lifeless or inanimate because it is only the scale. So it's only about justice or vyapara, that is marketing, business. So this also is the way to study. So Leo and Libra, there is no fear. Libra and Leo, once again, there is no fear. You can see Leo and Libra, there is no fear here. Okay, so but with Libra female, they match it along with Capricorn and Virgo males. So there is a lot of research behind this. I will not go into the deeper subjects of you know, that is one point and all those things which is actually included in this. Because for example, if I take up Gemini and if I will be matching it with Leo, a human and a beast, this, whether the beast will dominate the human being or the human being will dominate the beast, think about it. This Koota is in particular done to understand who is the dominant partner in the marriage. So who is the dominant partner, and if you are going to match two dominant people together, then it will be difficult. That means both will be trying to rule. So we need to see who is recessive, who is dominant, by understanding the characteristics of the Koota. But for the way, for the basic level, let us understand that this table is important, and we will go through this table. We will go through the exceptions, remedial measures for marriage matching. I will be doing it in detail after I finish all the Kootas. In that, I will also take up Vashya Koota, wherein remedies have to be sorted for. Thank you very much for today's class.